past.
And all of those questions, as your report started coming into the Obama administration in the second term around 2014, around the time that he joins the board of this Ukrainian gas company, Burisma. The New York Times, at least, Adam, has reported that Hunter Biden was paid somewhere around $50,000 a month for his work. Do we know that to be factual? And also, if it is, can you tell us what he did for this company? What did that work entail?
Yeah. So initially, one of his partners actually was put on the board, a guy named Devin Archer, and Devin Archer then brought Hunter in, and Hunter was working as an of counsel for a law firm, and the idea was that Devin wanted to see if Archer could work with this board, this new board, international board of directors for Burisma, to put together a governance plan that would help the company appeal to Western investors. And so that's how Hunter sort of initially gets involved. He doesn't tell his father anything about it, per the don't ask, don't tell policy that goes back to when he first got into the business world. And he eventually was offered this position. The $50,000 a month, I've been told the same thing, but I was also told that it kind of depended on the month. Some months he was actually working more as a lawyer for them and he got paid more, and other months he got paid less. But nonetheless, it was a sizable chunk of change that he was receiving. He really had no substantial Ukraine experience. He had no Ukraine experience and no substantial experience in the energy sector at that stage in his career. And so, the suspicion was among people who worked for Joe Biden and some State Department and White House officials was this was an effort on the part of Burisma to curry favor.
But
they never raised it.
Right. I just want to deal in fact, because there is so much speculation out there and there is zero evidence that Hunter Biden or Joe Biden did anything wrong here. That said, as you know, Adam, everyone this week is talking about one line in your reporting, and that is about his work on that board. And you quote him as saying, Hunter Biden, Dad said, I hope you know what you're doing. And I said, I do. This week, we heard the former Vice President Joe Biden say, quote, and unequivocally, quote, I've never spoken to my son about his overseas business dealings. I know you've talked to Hunter Biden this week, this has all sort of evolved and bubbled up. Has he made that more clear for you?
Not really, no. We hadn't talked about that. I think when you look at Joe Biden's statement, it's rather vague. I think it also depends on the timing. So what happens is that aides to Biden really are either too intimidated or they don't feel comfortable raising the issue of Hunter with Joe Biden. This is at a period of time when Joe Biden's other son, Beau, who's like a lifeline for Hunter, is entering kind of the final year of his life before he dies of a brain tumor. And so it was the family issues were extremely sensitive, and all of Biden's aides knew that, and they were really, really reluctant to talk to him about Hunter's business activities and the potential problems it created. That there was a slight change that came just before Joe Biden went back to Ukraine in December 2015. So this is a good year and a half after Hunter joins the board. One of Biden's advisors, a guy named Amos Hochstein, he raises it with Joe Biden. He doesn't say, you should tell your son to get off the board. He just wants him to be aware that it's probably going to be raised by the media, at least, during the trips. And then after that, Hunter gets a phone call from his father saying, I hope you know what you're doing. And he says, I do. And that's it. That's the end of the conversation.
So, Adam, let me end on this. One of the last parts of your piece, and I quote, and yet to many voters, the controversy over Hunter Biden's dealings will appear to have been avoidable, a product of Biden's resistance to have difficult conversations, particularly with those involving his family. My colleague Michael Smirkanish asked you a really important question a few days ago, and I think it's worth following up on. Is this a case of just bad optics and not anything more?
Well, I think there's kind of two separate issues here. The issue of whether it was wise of Hunter Biden to take this position at Burisma when his father was guiding policy in Ukraine, and the wisdom of Biden and Biden staffers once they knew that, not to ask Hunter to step down. I think that is a legitimate subject of scrutiny. I'm not saying it's illegal in any way. I'm just saying that's where the optics come into it, and maybe it's even worse than bad optics. It sort of undermined American policy of promoting, fighting nepotism, fighting, you know, these kinds of problems that Ukraine has in a large scale. So that's one issue. The other issue is, did Joe Biden use his office in order to fire a prosecutor to protect his son? That's the one where I found no evidence to back up and a lot of evidence. Yeah.